Itchford's pass. We have an official's timeout on the field for a measurement.
Hello and welcome to another edition of Friday Night Football. And we have a measurement here.
First down and 10 for the Marauders. The ball is placed at the Carlson 44-yard line. Timeout Carlson, their last of the game. Ian Stewart's pass is caught by number 4, Julian Poole, for Marauders' first down. And that is the end of tonight's game. With the wind-up Bears 7, the Carlson Marauders 14. Thank you very much for coming out to tonight's game and celebrating the 65th Band Sweetheart. Ladies and gentlemen, on the schedule, next week's game is against Melvindale, and it is listed as an away game. That game has been changed and will be a home game right here at Jim Johnston Memorial Field starting at 7 o'clock. Again,
Mr. Pat Hain, I am Jason Grass.
Oh, that was the Downriver League Classic right there. And there was bargain food to be had. The Bears took one on the chin, but they won in week number 9, so they qualified for the playoffs. So, good news. Friday night football, yes indeedy. Good game, 14-7. Well fought. And some school buses here, look at this. Look at that front grill. Beautiful school here. One of the entrances, and then if you can read that. Some nice lighting, and then like a nice woodcut. And the rail lines cut right through. Trains rock.
Come on, come on, come on.
The Wyandotte Bears. So here in the beautiful city of Wyandotte on 6th Street, looking in a southerly direction, there's a neon sign. Upon closer inspection, looks like they have a TV. 3-4 dollars. Yeah, when I left, I made sure I used the side door. Here's a beautiful smokestack chimney, but it's rather dark. But this is for a school, but yeah, quite the smokestack. I was told there was another neighborhood place down yonder, and you'd never know until you were right up on it. Then you see some of the neon signs, and but Wyandotte has a claim to fame. We'll check this out very shortly. Red light district at first, but no, it's fishy nonetheless, but Pabst, it's like a neighborhood gig kind of thing. So they have a map of all this stuff, and look at this. It's a historical bar map, and they are the former world record holder. And there's Frank's Cafe right there. So somehow they lost the crowd. Most bars per capita. So what gives? And then they had a happy birthday thing here. And you have to have good eyes to follow it all the way through. This is the first time I was here, but they follow the Bears, and I just came from that game. But they made the playoffs, so they will be playing a game this Friday. And those, like, the Mega Millions thing, whoa. I made sure I got in on that action. Well, now have to walk back to where I parked, and it's kind of a scary neighborhood here. He loves bacon, but don't we all? But it looks like people have gone before us. Yep, some neighborhoods are scary to be sure. But Wyandotte, fiercely independent city, their own electric, their own gas, their own water, their cable, I think everything. Here they have the winding staircase with the chandelier. Look at that, just like they did in the South. And DET.com is the website. Here, though, it's a little dark, but I got a great camcorder that's good in low-light conditions. But this is the Wyandotte Bear, and it's a classic bear. Kick-ass bear. So my suggestion, though, is light it up at night. Have a nice little floodlight. It's a classic bear. They do have some nice street lighting here in Wyandotte. And light rain here, 42 degrees. So we're pretty accurate here. This would be a single lamp model. We'll be right back. Okay, then a nice sleep. The next day, I think I'm going to search the contest and look how everything went down. Haha. So there's five games always played there, and there you have all the scores. Gibraltar Carlson, we saw 14. Wyandotte had 7. But here's the updated after 8 weeks. Woodhaven and Carlson are tied at 7-1. Allen Parks qualified at 6-2. Trenton and Wyandotte, they need one more victory. Not to worry, folks. Not to worry. All right. This was Sunday. And I got a bear from up north. And so he's doing the front porch thing. Here, low on bird food. That's the last I have in the bucket. But I have a plan. Matt, get ready for winter, too. All right, well, the Lions had a bye week. But nonetheless, I decided to check out Detroit. The vine action there is really pretty cool. Then casino action to the right, it casts a big shadow. But then you see downtown straight ahead. And nowadays, free parking. Whew, it's hard to come by, but the casinos offer it. So, gonna check it out from the 9th floor, which is like the tippity top. There's Motor City Casino Hotel. There's the train station thingy. The DTE Energy. And then that's where I parked. But you get a better view from the 8th floor. And you can see kind of like an urban type farm action thing here. The church, the Little Caesars Arena, and it's got the Little Caesar up top. So if you fly by, you can see a Little Caesar smiling at you. I haven't seen that yet, but if I get a window seat, I'm gonna try. There's Comerica Park, Ford Field. The Lions had a bye week, so not to worry. It wasn't too crowded or active downtown, but yet more active than in years past. Look at this, the fountain's going. Oh, I love this building here, the architecture. And then look at this nice quote here. Well, I'll be. I don't think I could have said that better. The lobby light, and then let's see, well, the logo. Now those scooters are all the rage. Here in a big building in the Fleur de Lis. And it's Lucy and Ethel's Diner and More. the building with the cherry on top, and it was a good backdrop day. The blue sky. It was not a bad day for background. The castle, and it's an American castle. I can tell. I just know it. There's different discounts in effect here. Sometimes they post what rate. A lot of times not, though. All right. This is the Rosa Parks Transit Center. And they have the neat canopy thing here. Picked up maps for two routes. And they have the Midtown Loop. So there's maps, you can get your bearings. And the strike thing here. Job should be enough. Here, rate in effect, $10. So I got it posted there. Here in Urban Garden, wasn't open here though, because this was a Sunday, but. And a lot more people walk the dog. Then there's some intricate details sometimes above some of these entrances. There, the Guardian building. David Stott building, and sideways though. And the marathon, so it's a whole weekend thing here, so. And look at that, mass transit. Something special coming soon. Oh. Can't wait. Tell me. No. It'll come out eventually. They're the Sailor and Soldiers Monument. The tunnel bus. So if you want to go to Windsor, you can do that. And the Grand Trunk Pub. That's what a witch's hat looks like. And they have ghosts. That I was sold there. That's all I should have said at the top. We have ghosts. I'm good. DET.com. So the Bears, I'm okay kind of like with the Bears, but they're in the same division as the Lions. The benefit. So I was just keeping tabs on this. But there says it's a plus there's bears on the Alaskan border. It's a big bear thing this Sunday. But inside the bar, the nice ceiling treatments there. Like the Baltic ceiling.
Grand Trunk GT.
All right, well, they're going to fix this up. How about it? Ford Motor. Woo-hoo. Look like back then. And a nice ceiling, the lighting. He's up to something with that room. You just know it. Like a knowing. What's that ginger? What it is. Here's one of those bike deals. Well, there's two different companies there. Bird. If you are so inclined. This one says helmet is required. I don't know what happened to you. Things seem to work quite well. Detroit's gathering place. Here we go. It there. Then those were the statues there were recently refurbished. This, well, they haven't figured out what to do quite yet with the National. Temple of Odd Fellows. I think we all feel in some way we can be part of that. Nobody's quite that normal, really, are we? An outdoor patio here. This is big, certainly for St. Patrick's Day. And they have the countdown going. And some of these actually have a backwards like clock. So I'm not sure if that daily thing was accurate or not.
Cricktown Casino and Hotel. Wisdom flows through books. I've seen that before, but it's good sometimes, I guess, that it would sink in, reinforce it. Free. Somebody took that literally. That was a few years back and stole it for the bronze or whatnot. So they had to redo it. So it's probably attached a little better. But, let man be free. But, yeah, we need to try it.
Did you see my development?
Queens, it's like, is this New York? Now open. It's a bar. Yeah, so this is inside the bar. We have a little study area, I guess. But there's a lot of nice architecture, certainly, in this neighborhood. The detour, doesn't matter which way you go. Either or. They're doing the Hudson site. They got a hole in the ground. The Shinola Hotel. So they have a little diversity. The watches, the bikes. Now the hotel. Yeah, Woodward Avenue is getting reinvented. It's been long overdue, but if done right, the growth spurt will be quite nice. Well worth it if we plan this out correctly, too. Chubby girls. Nowadays, it's probably not politically correct. So maybe it's good that it's fading out, but some of us will know it was always there. Advertising's crazy sometimes, the way things work. But yeah, you gotta watch for these tracks. You gotta watch for these guys, too.
Thank you.
is like Stop in the Name of Love statue here. Also kind of for mature audiences only. See more of these murals too on the side of buildings. Epicus beer. Well, everybody likes beer, right? Then across the way, I think this building was recently just sold. We'll have to see what happens. But next door, Cliff Bells. They were setting up for a performance later in the evening. I just said, listen, I just want to have a drink, take a look. Beautiful ceiling. The decor. Set you back in time. The ladies take the high road. Gentlemen take the low road. It's a classic. So the entertainment is top notch. The food's supposed to be pretty good too. Here's the logo. I'm just getting all warmed up. Well, it's dusk. It's getting dark a whole lot earlier these days. And when we move back to Eastern Standard Time, get dark just after 5. All right. Time to begin the descent. All right. Then, this was a surprise. I had business in the area, but Channel 7, I saw the news crew, and I saw 94.7 with their tent. So then I swung back around.
Everybody here, everyone, just want to say thank you for CSX and all the listeners and everybody here. Bob Seger over some. Seger Boulevard is going to happen, right?
Yeah!
And number two, Ohio State sucks.
Yeah!
Treat, right? Ben, we were getting calls from around the country about this. Guys in Tennessee and stuff are hearing about this.
They are going to donate $3,000 to them. Just their way, on your behalf, all right? That's what it's all about, man. Now, if you haven't heard, over here where we got the little registration box where it's, you can get those I Support Bob Seger roads. Yeah, right around there. Okay, we'll be doing that as well. I want to make sure I say hi to everybody. Like I said, Aaron's up.
I'm trying to take a sneak peek here. But the street was blocked off, actually. They had the barricades set up. Here. Bob Seger Boulevard. And so, Channel 7 was out here in a band. Allen Park Theater. Those were the movies playing and their times. their phone number. And you can put your bike in there. Pretty much in sync, I like that. An Irish pub, you hardly ever see these anymore. So this, I had to do that Mega Millions because that was all the rage. That's all people were talking about. So $1 billion. It just rolls off the tongue pretty good. So I had to waste $4 just to say I was in. All right. There were five of these signs that were draped, and it does a zigzag kind of thing. It's like a lightning bolt shaped kind of thing. So, but with the barricade, it really wasn't open. Here they go, officially. So there were like five signs total in this zigzag kind of way. This would be the second one coming from the south. Make a right and then make a quick left in Bob Seger Boulevard. Continues. Yeah, and then up to Southfield Freeway here. Then, I have no idea. On week number 9, the final week of the regular season, I decided I'm going to look at the website here. And so that's what I did. And here are the scores for the Downriver League. Trenton won, so they get their sixth win and automatically qualify, as does Wyandotte Roosevelt. And so they get their sixth win. So five teams from the Downriver League qualify for the playoffs, and five teams are out of consideration. Okay, so playoffs are going to begin. Well, this Ann Arbor and the big game's out in East Lansing, but nonetheless, there's an event taking place in Carytown, so I'm going to walk down the street here. They have pie pumpkins for $2. Those might be regular for $1. And live glass blowing. This is my sister and brother-in-law, so they had a setup here and a demonstration.
You want a purple stem? We'll put a purple stem on there. We can go wild and crazy if you'd like. A blue stem?
Oh, that'd be pretty.
That does sound very pretty. Feel those ridges? They just knocked that pumpkin off. They're going to go ahead and give it a little smush to cover up where it broke off the pipe, and then they're going to stretch it. And then they're going to wrap it. Oh, Chris just told him lots of curls. Oh, yeah, we're going curl crazy. What's that, like 15 curls there? Oh, my goodness. I don't know if we have enough pumpkin for all those curls. Woo-wee.
One of a kind, baby.
That is one of a kind. Very nice. Woo. So now we need to make sure that that's attached to the side of the pumpkin. So he's going to use that torch to push it on, stick it on there. And then they're going to hit it with the gassy flame. That gassy flame is going to bring the metals in that iris stem to the surface. And it's going to turn it kind of silvery. But we also have some green in that stem. So it's going to be kind of a green and silver stem, which looks really nice. Oh yeah, that blue is really starting to pop out now that it's cooling down a little bit.
It was a two-day glass blowing event, and then artists, Saturday was the farmer's market, and then Sunday, I guess, was the artist market. But you could even park, I think, using these meters. But they had apples, apple cider, flowers, that kind of stuff. Good cloud day. This was very much a very interesting day to keep your eye to the sky kind of a thing. A lightning bolt. That's kind of like what Bob Seger Boulevard's like. Like a lightning bolt like that. Alright, well, they were working here on Saturday. They have the mini artillery. That little contraption. This is the historic district. Here's the website. So every Saturday, I like beer. I think I know who that guy is. Yeah, I think I know who that guy is, too. Wow. Then they have like an indoor market kind of thing. They have cheese, beef. Ooh, they got base. Fish. Then like an outdoor patio. Yeah, good cloud day. Oh, yeah, that's a good thing. I think we can all pretty much everybody agree on that. Okay. 1902, so this is a little bit back in the day, but look at the brickwork here. Nicely done. Part of the Zingerman's complex. Wow, they have quite a group of buildings. And the line
goes around out to the back. This shows the they have a roadhouse, separate restaurant there. Got a whole group of the buildings. Yeah, they've made a name for themselves in Ann Arbor, to be sure. This is like looking at the menu inside. The line went from outside to snaking through inside, and then halfway through you ordered from that big menu board. So then you could eat outside or inside. They had a kids' play area. Cakes, chocolates, coffee. Nearby a garden place. This. Yeah, a bolo. This kind of would smooth things out. Then, yeah, who would have thunk? Stacking pumpkins, here we go. Mini towers, this is a new one. I like that concept. So gourds and all that. Here, well, the city has these nice little maps. Kind of differentiate, or make a little difference between different neighborhoods. The downtown business district and Ferrytown and the like.
Oh, I'm sorry. That is not what we're going to do. Oh, he's going for the crackle.
Glass blowing.
Oh, crackling. So what he just did is he dipped it into a bucket of water. That water instantly chilled the outer layer of glass, causing it to crack. The inside is still so liquidy warm that the cracks are only surface deep, and it gives it a very kind of icy look, so it almost looks like ice, kind of little crackles in it, and it's really awesome.
Well, I just...
You get a dip. There you go. Ooh. Nice moisture air there. There you go. Free sauna day at the farmer's market.
Yeah, well,
all right, so it looks like he's crackled it enough. He is satisfied with that crackle effect.
All about the raffle. Blow hard, blow hard.
Oh, so we're doing a raffle up here. So you see those little icicle ornaments that are hanging right at the center of our stage there. If you'd ever want to come and make your very own icicle ornament, you can at our studio. The way you can do that for free. So they're going to blow a little bit more.
Blow.
He's telling him how many times he needs to blow in there.
Stop.
I think that was five blows.
Something like that.
Ooh, ah.
And it's actually bright orange. When it cools down, it'll be this color right here.
Look at this orange. Someone said that you put purple on there.
It'll be pumpkin orange. Oh, this is going to be...
This is going to be orange. All right. Our work and the way we sign our work is we use a stamp. So we put to do that, we need to create a little spot to put that stamp. Because right now at the bottom of that pumpkin, all of those little ridges meet up. And it's not a very good clean spot to put a stamp. So we add a little bit of clean glass, a little fresh dab of lather. And that's going to create a little bit of an indent too. So the standard kind of bottom of a pumpkin house kind of have it indents in a little bit. That's how we get that. Now they're going to poke a small hole in it, so as that cools down, the pressure inside and outside will equalize, and it will stay this, and it won't, like, explode. So if you don't do that, if you don't poke that hole, it'll actually explode from the pressure change. An iris. I know, they're standing in the rain to watch this beautiful pumpkin. Oh, fancy!
Whoa! Oh my God!
See, I see what you did there, Fred. So Chris is going to show that off, but he can't stick it out too far or else it'll get sprinkled on. We don't want that. But look at that crackly, that crackle orange pumpkin. It's exquisite. Oh, looks like we got a nice little pumpkin patch forming in that dealer over there.
Oh, yeah.
Ooh.
Pumpkins recently made have to cool down overnight. Do the slow cool. They had some artwork. And then it was like a rain, and it was kind of like they kind of mentioned it might be a funky kind of rain. And you can kind of see it a little bit starting up here. Here are some of the nice flavors for October. Look at the different fire hydrants and the time frames here. They're like gold plated here. This is the Detroiter. And this is in front of the fire headquarters. Always remember, never forget. And then this one ran from 1971, and then this one, man, it must be in the city of Ann Arbor, because I don't recall seeing those in my neighborhood. That style. All right. Ann Arbor has a little history. Keep an eye on the clouds. Yeah. We have a mural here, colorful, a bowl. Okay, well, the game was delayed. This was the big battle at high noon. And the game was delayed and all that. This, you could pay it forward. I've never seen this before. So, you have a sense of humor for what you could post something, and then if somebody walks up there, yes, they fit the description, maybe they'll get a free drink. Yeah. Here, get taught by a WeeBot. Cool. Shinola has these nice clocks all over the place, and for the most part, they're pretty close. Jolly Pumpkin, that's kind of the theme here in October. We were watching some pumpkins glass blown. And right now it's the harvest season for regular pumpkins. Here, Main Street, Ann Arbor. Now, if it was game day, the place would be packed. But sometimes it's a little easier to get around. This was the drive-thru portion over here. The main sign says drive-thru, but yeah. I had to rebuy my ticket. I didn't win the last go-around. I was upset. This time I said $2. Look at this. See, drive-thru. That's not accurate. So those are the... Those are the winning numbers there. Yeah, right. You can't win if you don't play. I keep hearing that, so that's my excuse. All right, it's dark down there. You knew something was coming up. We were under borrowed time. It's
play. The offensive line, that wide zone play.
The Irish pub, you hardly see these anymore.
Second and seven.
Here's some crane action. Traffic light. That is a well done piece of artwork there. Very colorful. And they're proud to be American, I can tell. And some businesses along the way. Thunder and lightning.
If you could go online and support us via petition.
All right. Okay.
Turns out my sister and brother-in-law did the lights here. How neat. Then up the street, Broken Egg, and the sun was back out, and just have a little bit to wrap out the top of the hour. We'll call it a wrap. Folks, though, thanks for watching. Hope you have a great week or weekend, whatever the case may be. Enjoy the fall season.
White streaks in there. Can we get some heat on this?
Oh, there's black there at the bottom. Damn sick. It's a GA on it. And they're next going to poke a hole in the bottom of the pumpkin. Hole's going to be a very important part. Without a hole, there's going to be air trapped in there. As it cools, that air will contract. It'll create a strong enough vacuum that can cause the glass to crack or even implode on itself. See what happens here? This is going to heat that glass up he has. He's going to place it in a mold. Knock that glass free. We're going to stick it on, draw it up, wrap it around the mandrel a few times. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Very sharp for its cut.